Hi guys, this is Matthias, and in this video, as the title suggests, I will try to explain to you why I so harshly criticize DICE over Battlefield 1. Yes, I'm pretty sure that most of you guys know what I'm talking about, at least if you've been following my channels over the last couple of months. And by my channels, I mean here on YouTube and on Twitch.tv. So let's first and foremost get some of the most obvious things out of the way. Matti, why do you keep playing the game if you hate it so much, if you're so angry, if you think it's so bad? Well, I think those are the questions that I need to answer first, because they're very important. Now, if you criticize a game and you point out the flaws of it, then you do that with games that you care about. Games that you want to be good, games that you want to function properly. If it's a game that you don't care about, then why would you criticize it? You'll just uninstall it and move on. But with Battlefield, this is the game type that I'm looking for. It has big maps, a lot of players on each map, and a variety of different vehicles. I enjoy both taking vehicles out and using them. Now, if you are the kind of player that I am, and if you like the type of game that I just described, well, you don't have that many options.
Mind your language!
I forget.
So now, another important reason that I want to bring up is, it has to do with feeling responsibility. As a YouTuber and streamer, even with my small channels, I do influence some people in their decisions to whether or not they're actually going to buy this game or whether or not they're going to buy a released DLC. Now, this is something that happens naturally if you are a content creator. Now, this is something that I think about quite a bit, and this is where I sometimes feel a lot of guilt. If people would buy a game because they're watching my videos or my stream, especially with videos where you can edit out whatever bad things happens and only focus on what makes the game good, then what I do, whether or not I do it on purpose, is that I'm fooling people to believe that they are buying something that is functioning much better than it actually is. I think this is dishonest and, simply put, just wrong. Now, obviously, it would be in my own self-interest to say good things about this game. It would make it easier for my channels to grow, which is, of course, important to any YouTuber or streamer. But me, I just couldn't do that if that meant lying. And I would feel like I would lie if I didn't clearly showcase to people the flaws of this game, especially if they are as big and bad as they actually are.
I'll cover on the other side.
Yeah, there are some people here somewhere.
Yeah.
So after I explain all that, a lot of people might be tempted to ask, but Matti, why don't you try to be more constructive in the way that you criticize the game? Maybe you should go through the proper channels, and why not bring up the problems in a calm and respectful way? Well, when you see me playing the game, I am into the game, and what you hear and see are just simply initial reactions. Now, the whole thing about being constructive, calm, and respectful, something I've already done, and I am far from the only one. But the problem is, of course, when this is constantly being ignored, you no longer see the reason to be respectful and constructive.
Played much plane lately.
No.
Just noobing around on the ground.
Now, some of you guys might be asking, is it really that bad? Are DICE actually ignoring a lot of big problems that we've had for a long time? Well, the answer is yes. And I'm not talking about the server lag that we had after the release of the In the Name of the Tsar DLC. Now, that's new, or, well, relatively new that it's that bad. We've had similar problems in Battlefield 1, and especially also in Battlefield 3 and 4, and maybe even before that, but probably not as bad as it was this time. Funny thing, however, is that no matter how bad a problem actually is, there are still going to be a lot of people that simply can't tell that there is a problem, and because of that ignorance, many times they will call people that criticize the game for whiners and, well, a bunch of other random insults. It's also very, very common that these people believe that they are a lot better at the game than they are, and that they believe that people are whining because they are doing bad, when in fact, it is the exact opposite. It is the good and experienced players that will first notice when there is a problem. If you have played In the Name of the Tsar and not noticed that there has been a problem, then you probably don't get on top of that scoreboard all that often. Now, when it comes to old problems, some of the things that has bothered me a lot has to do with movements of your character. For whatever reason, you still have this problem where your character just gets stuck on things that really shouldn't hinder your movement at all. Like tiny little rocks or tiny little obstacles that you should just step right over. But it's even more problematic with the animations that are related to movement. Many times when you need to trigger an animation in order to get over a small wall or something similar, even if you press the right key, your character just lays down on the ground, proning. This happens all the time. Many times the animation that I was talking about actually gets triggered, but you don't jump over the obstacle anyway. And this is something that we saw a lot of examples of, even as early as in the closed alpha. We saw it during the beta, and we still see it today. And the most common place that I'm thinking about is at the D flag on Sinai Desert, when you are by the train tracks and you want to go in the direction of C.
This is gonna be impossible. They're gonna camp that anti-air, and it reaches so far. Oh wait, that's not that anti-air. It's
I think it was
plane.
Yeah. On the left. It's that anti-air.
There's one on E.
Yeah, I killed him.
So yeah, I'm not going to bring up a lot of examples of what is problematic with this game. That's not what this video is about. This video is about why I say what I say and react the way I react. It's my way of standing up to the rest of the people in the community who I think deserves a game that functions. The whole argument, it's just a game, is in my opinion simply wrong. Me and several other people have paid over $100 for it, and with any other product that you buy or with any other service that you buy, it needs to function. It needs to work. There are even laws for it. But for whatever reason, this can be ignored with games time and time again. I think it's disrespectful and simply put bad of a big company such as EA to allow this to happen to especially the Battlefield series in basically every game. But yeah, that's me. That's my opinions. And I hope you understand where I'm coming from with this. So yeah, my name is Matthias, and I want to thank you all for watching.
I can't even strafe here because of the trees.
F on die again.
Yeah. Alright, let's see if I can get F and die again. I'll have to shoot him.
I can go and try to disable it.
Got a few shots on him. Two hits, three hits, a shot.
Yeah, I got him again. It's the same guy, Yeah.
Over.
Oh yeah.
The big one. He's on us.
Keep this up, I'm gonna go for him. Oh, he's not gonna keep it up.
Good bomb by pilots. Just crashed.
Trying the long range with the revolver.
Whoa. Yeah, there. Yeah, you see? We're taking some damage.
Come on, yeah. Get through the end game.
We are winning. Thank you.
Boss on the left.
Got him.
Snipers.
I need a vehicle so I can get rid of this bug. Oh, I can get into unknown's vehicle here real quick. This will be my saving grace. Bang. And the bug is gone, yeah. Yeah, one down.
Where bet you want to go?
Nice. Hang on.
Hey. What? Oh, from B side. That spawns on C are weird.
Did you get him?
Yeah. Oh, get back. Yes. Wait.
No. Wait, no. We have lost objective apples.
He's got 2 health.
I'm coming up.
Prone.
And he's not burning now. What?
On the left side of the building. Or left side of the room, rather. You go in.
Where are we? Out of the... On the map, we are not out of the map, but yeah.
On the map, we're not out of the map.
Yeah, you look at the minimap.
Go back, see.
In this corridor, it's inside the map for us, but we're still outside the map.
On the bar kills.
can't see it anymore. It's a car.
I think it was like kills with a bar and then that one pistol.
Oh yeah.
I burned that altitude quite a bit.
Nice.
He jumped out.
Let's take it.
You got his kit?
Yeah.
Nice.
Well done.
Eat it.
Shooting from D now. From E. Got it.
Go for that bomber.
Stable. I got wrecked, but he really loaded the bomber. The medic on the right, lower to the where the bomber was going. The few guys.
Oh, the range.
We'll let you have it.
Maltas
was a medic.
Yeah, Martin got me.
Oh,
the left one. My god.
Oh, he's right in the corner where I died. Right in that corner. He's right there. That revival. That was hilarious. And I had the rocket out. I just shot in the... There was a shot in the dark and I killed him.